last book is a collection of short stories, and it involves primarily one character who is a teenage girl named Jocelyn, who is spending the summer with her aunt and uncle in Maine and going to summer school. And she appears in the first story and in the middle of the book and in the last story. But the entire book takes place over one summer, and the other stories in the book don't directly relate to Jocelyn, but they relate to the community that she's living in temporarily. It was interesting to write about Jocelyn because I have a goddaughter, so I hang out with her and her friends, and I hear a lot. But also the community that I live in southern Maine, in the U.S., there are a lot of vacationers, so there are a lot of teenagers who hang around at night. And often when I write about things, it's not directly about people I know. It's more like overheard conversation. But I think what I was trying to do in the book was, yes, I mean, be true to how someone that age would think and what situation they might face, but also just have that be a given of the book. In other words, they are out of sync. They're out of step with the other people in the community in the way that teenagers form their own band, and anywhere, under any circumstances, they want to be alone. So she's very dependent on her aunt and uncle because her mother has sent her away deliberately, and she's in summer school. She doesn't want to be in summer school, so she's pretty sarcastic and pretty, on edge. I would say, for one thing, that there are a lot of people doing it. There are a whole lot of people writing now, and that in the last 20 or so years, a lot of it has been at least that the writers get some training at a university. It's very typical in the U.S. for writers to assume that they hope they can teach, so that's very old-fashioned notion. I mean, that's always been true of writers. They always tried to pick up jobs where they could, and you go where the job is. You don't necessarily go, where you would most like to live or something like that. But again, I don't want to say that there's a great discrepancy among writers or a commonality between them only because they've been in MFA programs, but statistically, the vast majority of everybody in the United States does have, at this point, almost everybody really who's published, who is an American, go to the MFA programs not just to learn how to write, but also because it's really one of the places you still can find yourself able to read and seriously discuss literature.